Wild radish has become a big problem around Australia. WA has radish resistant to multiple herbicide groups, which include glyphosate resistance, and phenoxy resistance is now developing in other states.
We crop about 2,200 hectares here, and there's probably a fairly good covering of radish over a lot of the farm.
In Western Australia's northern grain belt, wild radish is considered the most damaging of weeds, and growers are using a diverse range of control tactics, including new thinking about when to spray the weed.
We're probably adopting a two-spray strategy for radish in a lot of cases, an early spray and a later spray.
The change to targeting young wild radish resulted from trials carried out by DAFWA over 2 years. The research was funded by GRDC, as it was the Geraldton Regional Cropping Solutions Network that identified the work as a priority project.
And the outcomes of that has been to spray small radish, spray them twice and use excellent application. And that's a message that we're spreading to the whole industry now.
Peter says spray timing and application are often more important than product choice.
Our messages these days are to get people to move the spray window forward for wild radish, spray a first spray when the crop is perhaps two leaf, and then come back 3 to 4 weeks later with a crop more at this stage where we've got early tillering crop, but we can still get good herbicide application onto the weeds at ground level. Righto, so Wildy, we've got a oat crop here with a bit of radish in it. What are your thoughts? Time to spray?
Oh, definitely. I need to get on
it. As soon as we wait for them to be six leaf or eight leaf, there's only a few herbicides that will kill the bigger radish. So two spray of small weeds we've seen some exceptional results. Herbicides that can be applied at that two leaf stage of the crop, of a wheat crop, and that would be a Velocity or a Jaguar type product. And so we're talking about a Group C, Group H combination or a Group C, Group F combination. So if we've used an early Jaguar, then a Velocity MCPA late, or if we've used an early Velocity, then a 2,4-D plus another group of herbicide late on small radish is successful as well.
While the double early spray strategy initially costs more, the better radish kill pays off.
Well, we just need very good spraying capacity. We probably need to, a lot more of us getting nurse tank operators to have more water out in the paddock for our boom sprays. We're all spraying with higher water rates, which means we use a lot more water per hectare.
However, with better long-term radish control and a cleaner sample at harvest, Tony White has a sustainable and more profitable business.
Well, we've been able to up our cropping intensity on our farm in the last few years. And combined with better commodity prices, it's been quite a profitable move. Wild radish, I guess, is like any other weed. If we don't hate it enough, it's going to come and bite us on the backside. So we've just got to be on our toes and use every means possible to stay on top of it.
Peter Newman says that means growers must use diverse measures right across the country.
So the message, firstly, is if you don't have wild radish and you see it on your farm, jump on the problem fast. If you've got it, then you can learn a lot from what's happened in Western Australia, and that's about using diverse rotations, rotating herbicides, crop competition, harvest weed seed control, and whatever else you can throw at it, but the answer will not just be herbicides. For more information, follow the links on screen.